Hello everybody, welcome back to the complete edition of LA Noire on PC and 1080p. This is The Fallen Idol.
Phelps, Bukowski, you have a new case. Two women, possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
All right. Dude, I'm excited. Let's do this.
It'll be worse.
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too hard.
Look at you, bantering with the boy.
Brings a tear to my eye watching my caterpillar grow wings.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Educated, hardworking, straight as an arrow. I hate to break it to you, Cole, but you'll never fit in at Central.
Aww.
Isn't he the cop that won the medal and assaulted all the cases?
Thanks. You know what? That's nice. All right, let's get in the car. I know it's across the street, but I'm not gonna drive.
Can you drive to this one?
I wanna make Bukowski drive. Yeah, that's what we do, man. Every time. Come on, man. Let's go. Crash site, 7:50 a.m. We made it. There's the car. And here's us.
Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard. Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy MCAFEE. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight.
What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passenger's a Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. She's pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to Central Receiving. If you want to take a look around, I can stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. She cuts rough.
Thanks, man.
This ain't the red carpet, so get out of my lens.
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
Thank you. That's exactly who I'm looking for. I also do want to take a look at the car itself, so it'll be a good opportunity to do that. Okay. There it is. What a sight. Literally.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Okay. That looks like underwear. What is this? Come on.
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
That was a weird thing that I just did there with the mouse. All right, we got a purse with a letter, it looks like. What is this?
She's a long way from home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What does it say? You're worried about your father, don't be always forgiven. He's a hot temper and very proud. You're a good, decent girl, dear, and you're not made for Hollywood. I was 15 once myself. Want to be just like. Anything else? Emma and Molly miss you. Okay. Awesome. Letter from her mom. Kept in her purse. Kind of sweet, actually. That's it. Cool. License plate. I assume that belongs to this car. Maybe. No? We don't care about it. Put it down then! Honk honk! Let's see here. Oh! Oh! Around! Oh! Come on! Man! There it is. Wow.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
Yeah. I mean, like the passenger, I assume it's the young girl, bashed her head in there. Blood on the dashboard. Alright. Stock.
Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
Oh. Casting marks, huh? Wait. Bring it around. No. Almost. There it is.
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
Aha. Okay.
How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff? If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
I agree. Let's get there. We're going on up. Let's go see the driver. Let's do this. Alright, which way? This way. There she is. Discovered everything there is to discover here. Awesome. Let's talk to this lady.
Mrs. MCAFEE, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of this.
Oh, man. I think she's a little high, but I'll take it.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. MCAFEE. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
Oh, what is that side smile you're doing there? Yeah. Giving me a seductive look. You're high. I don't like this. There's something going on.
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
What more can you say? I found a letter from her mother. And I found a torn pair of underwear. So, what about that?
I think you're lying, Mrs. MCAFEE. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Matter of fact, I do.
Miss Hamilton's underwear were physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
Okay. You're trying to remember something else, though. Clearly. I wonder what it is.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
I'm afraid I can't do that, June. You're gonna have to tell me a little more.
I want to know what happened between you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it, and this is where I end up.
Mrs. MCAFEE, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news house.
Mrs. MCAFEE, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid.
Okay. Cool. Set a thing to the hospital. Mm-hmm. We're all done here. Let's go. Alright.
I knew it wasn't safe.
Bukowski, get prepared to drive. We're gonna do this together. You and I.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Get in the car, man.
KGPL to car 11K, 11 King. The car crash victim has regained consciousness at Central Receiving Hospital.
Central Receiving Hospital, 8:02 a.m. Go in. All right.
Hello, Detective Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room right behind you, Detective.
Thank you.
You can't hold me here. No, I
feeling
don't
better
need
since
to
this
be
morning,
manhandled
Jessica.
By a doctor. I need my lawyer.
My head still feels
Where
funny.
Is the telephone? Do you know
what
who
is
I
going
am?
On? All right. Oh, there's a thing. Oh. Traces of chloral hydrate in bloodstream. Recently administered. Do not administer further sedatives without express permission. Patient to be held for bed rest and observation. So, let's see here. Head trauma and soft tissue damage sustained in car accident. Residual traces of chlorohydrate and bloodstream. External bruising to genitals. Wow.
Just standing around here looking at me, not saying anything?
I'm looking at this thing. Another evidence of criminal abuse. Okay, so, wow, that's awful. Let's put this thing down. Let's talk.
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Well, what about the abuse that is written in your file there, right by your bed?
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
Well, I mean, come on.
We found your underwear in your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up. That was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. Yeah. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage.
Exactly. Like, what do you mean it's not my first time? So what? It doesn't mean... this is so weird.
We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
How about nope? I found a letter from your mom in your handbag, and she really wants you to come back home.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, Detective, why would I lie to you?
I don't know why, but you're lying.
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
Okay. And you're looking around.
Yep.
Not sure what's going on here. Huh. What is going on here, Jessica?
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. MCAFEE? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment?
I overheard Junie speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Junie. But they seemed okay yesterday, like they worked it out.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
I know, I'm sorry, but I feel so bad for her, like, honestly. Oh my god. It's not a doubt, is it? Like, yeah, she's looking... Oh, man. What do I do? Truth? Doubt? Truth? Intuition? I gotta try truth.
Jessica, I really need you to help me here.
I remember the mermaid.
Was the mermaid in the movie too?
No, it was on the front of a building. We pulled up in front of the mermaid.
Thank you, Jessica. You've been a big help. Here's my card. If you think of anything or you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
Oh my god, are you serious? I'm leaving.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her. There she goes. Come on.
Let's get in the car. Looks like I'm driving. Got a Taylor from a safe distance. The suspect is marked in red. Okay. Oh, taxi. Oh, come. Don't. Nope. God. Okay. She's turned. She turned. Right.
Ballard is definitely up to something.
Okay. Let's not lose her. Not to get too close either. Alright, she's stopped. Looks like at a red light or something.
She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
Yeah, clearly. Alright, nobody crash into me. Trying to do this right. Okay, oop. Stop. Let's see. What is she gonna do? Okay. Turning right. Okay. Oop.
Oh. Easy, Cole. Better back it off.
Sorry. I thought she... I thought she drove forward from there. Okay. Alright. It's fine. We're getting there, dude. Slowly but surely. Alright. This way. Okay. Oh! Careful. I think we did it. He's out of the car. What is this? A coffee shop she walked into?
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Okay. No problemo. Let's take a cover at the door. Enter the cafe without being seen. Let's go for it. Excuse me. Find a booth with it. Take two. We gotta find a booth with a newspaper. Oh, man.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Okay. Oh, my God. I can't believe it. Take cover at the door.
Oh, call
duck.
These grits?
All right, June. Don't freaking look at me this time. Come on. Come on. And there he is. Newspaper, newspaper. Got it.
Baby? No! I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want. Well, then make someone else do it! You still know people out here, don't you? Then make some calls! I'm gonna be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803. Sure, I got the film.
Okay. All right. She good? She walked out. She's in the car. All right. I'm out of here. Hey, June. Just in case you didn't see me. All right. Bishop's apartment. Let's go ahead and set our thing. Take two, but we did it. All right. When at first you don't succeed.
Can you drive to this one?
Try again.
So what's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy MCAFEE'S wife in the first place. Or he'd have done the job properly. MCAFEE will break a fella's legs just for looking at his broad the wrong way.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story?
I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
So if Ballard was doing someone a favor, why did they try to kill her?
Oh yeah, Bishop's apartment, 10:03 a.m. Get in there, quickly. Go, 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 run, 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 run. Up the stairs, open the door.
I'm Detective Phelps. We received a call about a domestic disturbance in apartment 803.
Oh, the detectives. Listen, Mrs. Bishop's pretty upset. Take the elevator and then left down the corridor. It's the last door on the right.
Okay, thank you. Stay off the moonshine! We got Mrs. Bishop. All right. Let's go.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
Yep. Alright. Where? This? Is this? Oh, no. Don't. Nope. That's not what I meant to do. Come on. Over here.
LAPD, ma'am. Are you in danger?
I'm alright now. You just missed them. Horrible, awful men.
Are you injured, Mrs.?
Mrs. Bishop. Gloria Bishop. Please, come in, officers. I'll just need to sit down for a moment. Forgive me.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am.
Just look at this mess!
We'll take a quick search of the premises, ma'am. You take a moment to gather your thoughts.
I will. Thank you, officer.
Okay. What do we got? New Testament. Is this anything?
Doesn't look like anything.
Yeah. Alright. Is this a vase?
Not much help.
Okay. You never know. What is this? Statue? Something?
This isn't what we're looking for.
God! What are we looking for? Anything here? Oh. Ding ding. Dude, it's going crazy. It's going nuts. Okay. What is this?
I don't think so.
Alright. I assume this is nothing as well. Looks like lipstick. Alright then. What's this?
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
Good question. The check right on the floor. Gay cowboys.
Presented to Mark.
Silver screen props. Oh, whoops. Clicked on it again by accident. Yeah. All good. All right. What is that? Night train. Some posters. Paintings. Okay. Oh! Matchbox! Pretty sure it's nothing. What is this? Another trophy of some kind?
Great Wall of Babylon. A replica of a replica.
Intolerance. Photo. What's this?
Looks like the old movie set downtown.
Mm-hmm. No further investigate. Okay, put it down. Alright. Up. It's like, I don't want to miss anything. Oh, there's money. Okay. That can't be anything. I don't want to miss anything, but there's just so much junk that for some reason... Come on, man! Alright, let's look at it. What is it? This? Come on, really? How's that? Why would you even look at that? Excuse me, Bukowski. Anything in here? Clock. Nothing?
Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Alright. Anything in this room? Got a piano. Play a tune. Oh, got a photo.
Looks like we found our mermaid. Who are these men in the picture?
My husband, Mark, and Marlon Hopgood. They work together on occasion. That's Hopgood's shop.
Okay. Let's talk.
Those men, I think they work for Guy MCAFEE. Do you know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy MCAFEE. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. MCAFEE alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
And what is that face? My God. That's a doubt.
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
Okay. And where is the set? You're looking very relaxed. I think you're telling the truth, actually. Okay.
Either we find him, or MCAFEE's people do, Mrs. Bishop. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find him first.
I do care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. I found the check in your apartment on the floor.
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, detective?
Sure. There it is.
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not MCAFEE?
Lorna works at a check-cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
Well, then what is that face? First of all, and second of all, why did he drug and then do awful things to a 15-year-old girl?
Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, detective. Are you sure you really want to know? The truth is, my husband likes them young.
And you think that's okay?
I was 16 when I first met him. I thought he was a genius, a magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, Detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
All right. Let's use a phone. Right here. Come on. Do it. Turn around. Use it. Good Lord.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thanks.
Okay, good. Get our notebook, and let's go ahead and set ourselves a destination. Let's go talk to Hupgood. Whatever his name is. Let's do it. Alright. Elevator. Let's go ahead and skip this ride real fast. Unless Bukowski's got something to say.
An aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, and a movie producer's wife. We're finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous.
And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act.
Yeah, I knew he's got something to say. He always does. Alright, Bukowski. Let's do this. Let's get in the car. Let's go.
You can drive.
Get in here, man. We're going to a prop store. Jesus, you're slow. Let's go.
Mrs. Bishop knows more than she's letting on.
She doesn't seem to realize how much trouble her husband is in. The LAPD are the least of their worries right now.
Eh, you'd think she'd have gotten the hint after those hatchet men redecorated her apartment.
Maybe she's just loyal.
Or she's in on it. She didn't seem like your average giddy broad with nothing between the ears.
Or she might just be trying to buy enough time for Bishop to put a couple of oceans between him and MCAFEE.
Silver screen props, 10:32 a.m. Here we are. There's the mermaid. Let's get inside. Hi.
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We're investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
How'd you hear about that? I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way.
Kind of a creepy guy. But okay. Dude. Oh my god, look at that. This is awesome. Look at the bear. I like props. Props are fun. Ah. Almost feel like getting carrot top mode up in this. Sorry, that's a reference.
Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
That's right. Okay. Got some stuff in the room. Oh. Ha. Nothing. Huh. Alright, well. You know. Gotta try. Oh, what is this? What is this? That's what I think it is. Come on, turn it.
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people?
Dr. Stone Man, chloral hydrate warning might be habit forming. Poison. Ah. Nasty. What's this? More of these, things? Yeah, let's set it down. I don't think that's anything.
Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that?
Humor him.
Camera.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
With a camera. Okay.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
All right.
It can't be that way, Phelps. You couldn't fit a rat through there.
Hold on. Whoa. Whoa! Can you see through this as well? Oh my god. No. Oh, this is awful. This is awful. I don't like any of this. Let's get out of here. Let's go outside. Ooh, I need some air after that. Good lord. Oh, buckets. Buckets. Newspaper. Dope floods streets. Cops chase war surplus contraband. Nope. Well, I clicked on that by accident. Didn't mean to do that, but we did that now. It's 1 out of 13, apparently. all right. Well, looks like one of our shrunken heads. Right?
So this is where you sprang from.
Yeah. Okay. Not gonna take a look at the other one. What's this? Kinda looks like a fake wall, to be honest. And it is! Nice. Get in there. Aha! Uh-huh. What does that say?
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
Is there a further on it? 60mm. Okay, we have a location of the set. Nice sword. Okay, it's nothing. Okay. Oh! Oh, Mark Bishop, Jessica Hamilton! Yes! Further!
So what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test?
Interesting. It's just gone. Poof, right? What's this? Booze? I don't know. Alright, that's everything. There's a camera. Oh! Is that to the bathroom? Uh-huh. God. That is creepy. That is just awful, man. Okay, let's go. Let's talk to the guy. Or something. God. Just wanna like spit in his face right now. Hey, Hopgood. Better, something to say for yourself.
You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah. When Bishop is doing work for a studio, yes.
When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though. I haven't seen him around here in a while.
You're lying. Found the drugs, and I found an empty film canister.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here, and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant, and now you start throwing your weight around?
Yeah. I got a reason to do that, buddy.
A 15-year-old girl told me how she was drugged and molested at a casting house. I found the chloral hydrate in your drinks cabinet. You give me something or I will break your fucking jaw, Hopgood.
Bishop was here with June Ballard and the girl. A lot of producers and directors use this place. I'm not responsible for what goes on here.
MCAFEE'S men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If he really tried to kill MCAFEE'S wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
Okay. First of all, don't we... Hold on. Don't we already have... Oh, I can't feel locations right now? You're telling the truth. Didn't I already, write down the location of the movie set? I guess that's our... Right? It's gotta be our next one.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
What's the deal with you and June Ballard?
Look, buddy, I make props. I hardly ever meet the talent unless it's something tailor-made for them, like a sword or something.
First of all, I did find a sword. Second of all, well, there's a movie that the film canister that June was there with Jessica in the casting, so, you know.
You and Ballard are blackmailing Bishop. That's why he cracked.
You got nothing on me. My hands are clean on this.
Well, what I do have is this.
Enough. I've been in your peep room, Hopgood. I've seen your smut pictures and the camera setup. You made a movie of Jessica. I found the canister.
The deal is I get to sell the movies to burlesque houses and private collectors. These movie guys love seeing their cocks on screen. But part of the arrangement is I never film their faces. June had me film Bishop, and then she kept the movie for insurance. He went apeshit when he realized his face was front and center.
Who has the film now?
Who else? MCAFEE.
Ballard had what she wanted. Where does the money come into it?
What money?
$20,000 written to, was it you? Somebody, Hopgood.
Enough of the lies.
I told you, I get my cut selling dirty movies.
Well, also, you made 20,000 bucks.
Your ex was getting 20 large from Bishop.
If I wanted to skim 20 from Bishop, we'd do it through the movie budget. June said she'd sell him the film once the movie had wrapped, but guy wanted cash. He's in a cash-only business. You think I had a choice in this?
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earl, add Vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a Vice case. Have you been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a Vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlin?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get out of here.
This is bad.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg. You work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today, by any chance?
No, no, not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We could beat that.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. Mrs. MCAFEE hits him up for a movie part, happens every day. But Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. MCAFEE. Naturally, Guy is gonna get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy MCAFEE can be a very generous man.
I'm only gonna warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb, but polite.
But I'm a lot less polite, you smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small fry. And we don't waste our time on small fry. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. Is that clear enough for you, asshole? Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
Oh, got him! Ha ha! Yeah.
I don't think they like your little pep talk, Bukowski.
Oh, shit! Get us out of here!
Okay, we'll do. Or try to do. Oh, no, they're right there. I got Tommy guns.
I can't take the shot from here, Cole.
Okay, I'll try to get you up in there.
They really don't want anybody getting the fishing before they do.
Alright, I'm running. I don't know what I'm doing.
Wheel arches. Come on.
I'm just going for it, man. I'm just booking it. They're shooting at us. What do you want me to do? Oh, excuse me. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
I'll try for the tires. Keep your foot down.
Did we get someone?
We need to lose those fools, Phelps.
I don't know if we got him.
I'm a little exposed here, Phelps.
Oh god, something's happening behind us. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Look, I don't know. Where is he?
Make a move. We're sitting ducks here.
Bro.
I need to be closer, Cole.
Is he smoking?
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Oh god. Oh god. Excuse me. Yep, okay. Let's lose him. Let's get out of here. They take another car? No, they're
either
behind
us. Give me a good shot or get us the hell out of here.
Okay.
Let's see him chase us now. On to the movie set, Phelps. Let's roll.
Oh, Christ. They say working traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off, Bukowski.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down cops in broad daylight, MCAFEE really means business.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. I'm about done putting my life on the line to protect some child molester.
That's our job, unfortunately. They don't get to dole out the justice.
Yeah. Alright, I'm just gonna drive there myself right now. I don't know how far it is. Is it far? Let's check the map. Okay, where am I? Where do I need to go? I don't see it. Oh, there it is. Wait, where am I again? Where am I? I don't know. Either way. You know what, Bukowski? You drive.
You're behind the wheel.
That was really intense just then. What are we doing? Come on.
You know the way. You can drive.
Come on, man.
Isn't that the cop?
Just stand around. Jungle drums set. 5:30 p.m. Oh my god. This is a hell of a case, man. Good lord.
There's the slippery bastard now.
No. God damn it!
Oh,
Mark
dude!
Bishop, stop! LAPD!
You're coming with me.
Get it, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
Alright. Going after him.
11K calling KGPL, requesting assistance at 8th and Francisco, the abandoned movie set. My partner is pursuing suspect on foot. Code 3, KGPL.
Yep. Going after him right now. Jump over the thing.
We're trying to help you, Bishop.
Get back
here. This is all a big mistake.
Nope. It's definitely not a mistake. You're a molester. You need to be put in jail before you get killed. We need you alive for now. So get the hell back here. Come on, man. You're just making this harder on yourself. Come here. Okay, jump down very gently. Yeah. Better be safe than sorry.
It's us or MCAFEE'S boys. Your choice.
Oh my god, it's coming down.
I didn't do anything.
That's pretty cool, actually. Come on. Don't kick me in the face. Don't you dare. Nope. Come on, go up. He was about to kick me in the face. I know it. I know it. Just feel it. Get up. Up the ladder. Come on. Alright, man. I just want to pull up my gun, man. Just fire
Bishop,
a warning
that's
shot.
Enough.
Come on, why not?
That girl made it all up!
Oh my god. Here we go. Jump! Oh my goodness.
What the hell?
Back here. Jump. Over the thing.
Don't make this any harder on yourself, Bishop.
Go, 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 go.
It's June Ballard! She's blackmailing me!
Oh my god, I know she's blackmailing you. But you need to
stop. Hands in the air, Bishop! Move another inch and you're...
That's right.
Mark Bishop, you're under arrest for the attempted murder of June Ballard and the rape and attempted murder of Jessica Hamilton.
All right, I'll come quietly. Just don't kill me. If you found me, then MCAFEE'S goons will too. Oh, we need to get out of here.
Yeah, we do.
All right, but you stay close. Any tricks and I'll save MCAFEE'S boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place.
Okay, let's go. Come on. Lead the way. Let's go quickly. All right, we gotta...
Christ, detective, they're trying to kill me!
Gotta get him off the lot alive.
Last chance to back the hell down!
Oh my god, get in a cover. In a cover, I said. What is that? You shot my head off!
It's this way!
Okay, pick it up, put it back on.
MCAFEE doesn't make the rules.
Gotta
hear me?
Gotta look classy, man, no matter what. Oh, he's down.
Kill them, for God's sake! I don't want to die!
Sorry, I'm coming down. I'll be right there.
There's no way out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
Just gotta get my hat. It's all good. Just blowing people up. No problem. Get undercover.
Come on, it's this way.
All right.
Is this really the best MCAFEE's got?
Nowhere near effective.
Oh, God. I'm about to die.
God, they're everywhere.
Oh, God. Get undercover.
Can't make the shot.
You're alone.
Okay. Do I just not have the range? Or what? Dude, my screen is black and white. This is bad. I don't think I have the range. Honestly.
You're pretty great for a dead man.
Okay.
This is
just run. Just run quickly. Get it. Get undercover again. I think I got a rifle this time. Yes. Oh my god. Much better. Alright. Let's come on. What? I'm stuck? Hello?
Come on, let's keep moving.
I'm stuck again. Can I not move with a rifle? Nice. Those look explosive, so I'm just gonna keep an eye out on that.
Let's go! Stay with me!
Okay. That was really awkward. Oh, those barrels. Here we go.
Shit, really hurts.
The statue there. There's a ladder leading to the ground.
We got that
Follow
guy.
Me. Come on.
We're coming down. Go, go, go. This is a big ladder. Dude, my hand's gotta be all messed up now. This has gotta hurt.
Get him over here, I'll cover you. Come on, the cavalry's here.
Okay, down the ladder. Go, 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 go. We're almost done. I feel it.
All right, let's go. Now.
Oh god, get cover.
Those barrels at the base of the elephant column. They're full of gasoline. Shoot them, quickly.
Where?
Shoot those sons of bitches.
Stay down.
Bishop, that's enough.
I think we did it.
Follow me. We need to get him to the car.
Okay. Bishop.
Keep them off me for Christ's sake.
All right, we're doing this.
Find some cover.
Got him. Those are some decent shots.
Come on! Throw some lead at those
Okay. What do we got happening? Anybody gonna come up those stairs? Or, I assume those are stairs.
Get him to the car! I can cover you from here! You're almost there!
Almost, almost.
Weapons on the ground, now!
Oh my god. Almost. One more. Come on.
I'm gonna put holes in you, asshole.
Come on. Oh. Got him. Awesome. Finally.
Now this is what I call a result. Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin. for statute rape and attempted murder, so he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy instead of sticking it to little girls. That is justice with a capital J, Detective Phelps. You've developed such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It was good working with you, son.
Oh, man. All right, it was a pleasure, Bukowski. See you around. Whew. Man. It's a good time, man. Look who it is. Hey, Roy.
Phelps, Bukowski, this your work?
Can I help you, detective?
Sorry, Cap. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't. This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy MCAFEE'S private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Go right ahead.
Get in. I'm buying.
Oh, yeah. Oh. All right, we got promoted, traffic complete. Oh my god, we're getting promoted to homicide. Reaching the apartment earlier would have meant a chance to give MCAFEE'S goons. What for? Anyway, thank you very much for watching this. I'll see you guys in the next case and homicide. Later.